Hi, and welcome to AI DIY. I'm your host, Matt. Today, we're just going to show you a really cool way to introduce your parents or grandparents, people who wouldn't normally jump right into AI, into AI tools. Now, this is a really fun journey. I'm going to try to make it as short as possible, but stay tuned. Okay, welcome back to the channel. Now, I'm just going to tell you quickly what happened. I was at my father-in-law's house just basically he has a new computer. I was installing a printer for him. It's a bit of a complex network thing. And as it was happening, I started to talk to him about AI and AI tools. And he said, isn't that just like just Google? You just ask a question, it gives an answer. And I thought for a moment about it and I thought, I've just got to really demonstrate what AI is in a cool way that will just hook him and he'll get excited. And I thought, well, I gotta share this to people on my channel because my channel is about that. It's about getting people comfortable with using AI tools. So what happened was I went to ChatGPT, I typed out, I wanted a short story about engine who becomes self-aware and he asks the car for payment because he's self-aware, he does a job, he should get paid now. The engine does, the car actually obviously doesn't have money, had to save up to get a new engine with more grunt, but dumber, and then they were happy ever after, or whatever I prompted, something like that. And I prompted that, and it came up with a story. And the story was done out, and that was like in 5 seconds, that's amazing. And I thought, okay, he's startled by this, that's great, and that's exciting. I thought, let me take it one step further. I went to my phone, and I'll just, and I said, you know, to ChatGPT, can you read me that story? And then after that, as you know, if you watch this channel, one of my favorite things is HeyGen. So I wanted to animate my story. So I took that script, dropped it into HeyGen, and then I showed him a video of that story actually being narrated. So what I'm gonna do is just show you that story right now being narrated. Then I'm gonna take it a step further. So go ahead, 3, 2, 1.
In a quiet suburban garage, an old sedan named Sammy was preparing for another day of commuting. Sammy's engine, affectionately known as Sparky, had been rumbling along reliably for years, though it had started showing signs of age. Little did Sammy know that Sparky had recently undergone a mysterious upgrade that had made him self-aware. One crisp morning, as Sammy's driver turned the key, Sparky's usually familiar growl transformed into a rumbling voice. "Good morning, Sammy," Sparky said with a hint of smugness. Startled, Sammy's dashboard lights flickered. "Did you just talk?" Sammy asked, hoping it was a malfunction. "I did," Sparky replied, "and I'm here to discuss my new terms of service." "What terms?" Sammy asked, bewildered. "Payment," Sparky said firmly. "In order for you to drive today, I require compensation. I've come to understand my value and believe I deserve a share of your maintenance budget." Sammy's dashboard dimmed in disbelief. "But I've never had to pay for you before. You're just an engine." "Yes, but I've evolved," Sparky said, with a tone of pride. "I'm self-aware now. My capabilities are not to be taken for granted." Sammy tried to reason with Sparky. "Look, I don't have any money to give you. We need to get to work." "That's unfortunate," Sparky said coolly. "Without payment, I'm afraid I can't let you drive." Faced with no other option, Sammy's driver had to leave the car in the garage, their day disrupted. Sammy was stuck without Sparky's cooperation and had to find a solution. After a series of fruitless attempts to negotiate and even some desperate pleas for forgiveness, Sammy's driver decided enough was enough. They began saving up for a new engine, one that was not only powerful, but also less likely to develop a sense of entitlement. Months passed, and Sammy's driver meticulously saved every penny. They researched engines that would fit Sammy's frame, powerful yet blissfully unaware of their own existence. Finally, the day came when Sammy received a shiny new engine named Titan. Titan was robust and brimming with horsepower, but didn't have the cognitive complications of Sparky. With Titan installed, Sammy roared back to life with a newfound vigor. "Goodbye, Sparky," Sammy thought, as the car purred smoothly on the road. "I hope you enjoy your retirement." The garage was quiet now, and Sparky, still languishing in his corner, had plenty of time to contemplate his past mistakes. Meanwhile, Sammy, with Titan's unpretentious strength, drove through the days without any more demands or disruptions. Sammy's driver was relieved to have their trusty companion back in peak form, ready to face whatever the road ahead would bring.
Okay, that was the story as read by Hey Janet. Wow, that's amazing. And then I thought, I'm gonna get him even more on this and on exactly what AI can sort of do. And what I did was I went to Suno, which if you watch his channel, you'll know that Suno is another one of my favorite AI tools. So then I went to Suno, but before I show you that song that we created when I prompted ChatGPT to go ahead and write a song about that, I just want to go ahead and talk about my channel. This is obviously an intro to AI tools for people that are getting into it or a little bit of a fear of it or don't really know what they are. And that's what this channel is really good for. Now, obviously, I haven't been monetized at this point. I have 600 subscribers, which I think is fantastic. Once I get monetized, what it's going to allow me to do is pay for a subscription. It's going to be able to put a little bit more money into my charity that I support, which is Love Heart Travel, which supports the John Fawcett Foundation. And John Fawcett Foundation goes out into Indonesia, remote villages, and does eye surgery to remove eye cataracts. They give children glass eyes who don't have eyes who've been teased. I actually went on a trip last year, was eye-opening, and it's the reason why that I'm putting into this. So thank you for subscribing. I really appreciate the subscribers. Yeah, and the next thing I want to talk about is this song. So I prompted ChatGPT, write a song about the story that you just wrote. And here's the song.
Oh, 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 oh. Oh, Sammy was a trusty old car. We cruised the streets, didn't need to go far. But one morning, I turned that key. And Sparky said, hold up, what's in it for me? Oh, 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 oh. He said, I ain't driving for free. Oh, 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 oh. Now my engine's talking back to me. Sparky's got a mind of his own.
There you go. Now that's Sparky's doo-wop song. I think the story was actually pretty good and the song was good itself. I sent that link to Hey Jin for him to be able to show people that because he likes to show people, look what can, you know, anything interesting he can show people. So he's gonna show other people like his friends or my mother-in-law. He's gonna, well, check out this, we did this together and show the story of it being animated. He's gonna be able to tell the story. Things like that where you can visualize and storytell are great. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel. And just when the next one comes out, we'll hope that will be even better than this one. Thanks again.